Vending machines in public schools is a controversial topic and involves many larger issues, including school funding, personal choice, and childhood obesity. Though freedom of choice is an important value in America, it is also the responsibility of the schools to teach wise, informed life decisions and to promote a healthy present and future for its students. What is the true cost of vending machines in schools? One benefit of having snack and pop machines in schools is that it generates a large amount of revenue for the schools. The Seattle School District earns about $330,000 a year from its vending machine contracts. Though snack machines may benefit schools in some ways, the question must also be asked, what other non-monetary price are schools and students paying? As the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services explains, being overweight during childhood and adolescence increases the risk of developing high cholesterol, hypertension, respiratory ailments, orthopedic problems, depression, and type 2 diabetes as a youth. Schools influence and shape a child's life and therefore have a responsibility to promote the healthiest life possible for each child. What are we teaching by placing vending machines in schools? By placing these machines in schools and making unhealthy snack choices readily available, we are teaching students that eating these items is acceptable. Instead, we should be promoting a healthier lifestyle. According to the Department of Health and Human Services, only 21% of kids get their recommended 5 servings of fruits and vegetables a day, while 32% of adolescent girls and 52% of adolescent boys consume 3 or more 8-ounce servings of soda per day. Kids today are misguided in their eating habits, but schools have the power to change this attitude. What are some examples of existing regulations? In 2003, California passed a bill that eliminated soda machines from schools, replacing them with milk, juice, and water machines, and limited student access to only 1/2 hour before and after school. Schools throughout the country should follow this example and replace the chips and cookies with veggies and nuts, allowing students to continue buying snacks at school, but snacks that will not harm their health and will teach a better lifestyle. Eliminating unhealthy choices from schools is not an infringement on the rights of students. It is a way of the schools teaching, through example, how to live a healthy lifestyle.